women that have been, you know, suffering from, I mean, like that have experienced politically motivated rape. And we are inviting churches, human rights organizations, NGO, women and youth groups to support our campaign and become part of our Christian peace movement. So far, Zimbabwe Christian Peace Movement is part of the Zimbabwe Human Rights Forum. And the Zimbabwe Human Rights Forum is based in Zimbabwe, and they've got 27 other NGOs that have joined our peace movement. And we're also in touch with advocacy research unit. Advocacy research units are the ones who work with the women that were raped, you know, they document the cases. So they've got all the statistics. So when we got in touch with them, we said that whenever we're doing our campaign, for it to be, for people to understand that this is true, you know, people always want researchers. They want to find out, where did you get that information from? So that's where we got in touch with advocacy research unit, and he said, you people have been working with the women since 2008. Now we need your support. We are standing and speaking up for the women that have been raped and to stop this. But can you back us up? So they said, we want to become part of this peace movement. So they're also part of the Zimbabwe Christian Peace Movement. And we've also got World AIDS Free. They also have also got statistics, and they've also been very passionate about this. If you want to find out more about them, they have a campaign called Electing to Rape. It covers about sexual terror in Zimbabwe and everything, and they're the organization. They're based in America, and they also are helping these survivors that are based in Zimbabwe. And last week we went to Manchester and we met up with the Restoration of Human Rights in Manchester, and we were welcome there, and they also want to become part of the Zimbabwe Christian Peace Movement. I also spoke to Maslin. I don't know if you know Maslin from Zorro. She's also joined the peace movement. She said that Zorro would want to become a part of this. So I was here today to talk to your branch to say this, since this is a women rights issue, and internationally rape is a crime against humanity. I think this is now time for us to form and become a powerful voice, because you know the women in Zimbabwe, the sad thing is that in 2008 when they were raped, they expressed these issues to the political leaders, but nobody heard them, nobody did anything for them. So that is why there's a need for us to organize as women as much as we can to lobby together, because this is just injustice taking place. It's a great injustice, and it's not only a women rights issue, but it's a human rights issue that needs all of us coming together to stand strong and support the women in Zimbabwe. You know how our mothers and our sisters and everybody is suffering at home. Everybody is suffering, and it's not a time for division anymore. So that's why when we formed the Zimbabwe Christian Union, the movement, as Christian women, we said it's time to also get the churches involved, because we've got many churches that can be playing a big part in what we are doing. They can be carrying out biblical justice as well. You know, in the Bible it says speak up for the poor, help the widows and orphans and all this. So we can tell the churches to get involved in what we're doing, so that our issues can be addressed from whatever angle we are coming from. And I also wanted to tell you that organization called Women of Justice Arise Bank is based in Stoke-on-Trent, but it's a women rights organization, and it was started by refugee women. And we work with women from all nationalities. We are based in Stoke-on-Trent, and we offer different support activities for refugee and asylum seeking women, and we usually do campaigning. We are the campaigners. We campaign wherever we bring our campaigns. Women of Justice Arise, they are the ones that mobilize other women, and we go on the streets and we lobby for domestic violence and sexual violence. But I am pushing sexual violence because I'm having to let people know that in my country, women, we've got an issue. Whenever I'm talking with other women from other nationalities, I'm not just marching by myself. I say I talk to all women, British women. I've told them, I've spoken, I belong to a network of other women. So I tell them, and next year, the good thing about this, my right to vote, not your right to rape, is that the British women are celebrating their right to vote in 2018, mm-hmm. and we've got our issue of not voting, so it's going to become a big thing that others are saying they've got a right to vote and we don't have a right to vote. And they were saying that we'll definitely back you up. And we actually did a radio interview on BBC's talk about 3 weeks ago, and it was well received in the community, and some British ladies also came with us, and they were talking about how their right to vote is for them, and we were talking about our situation, and the reporter who was interviewing us said, oh, is this really happening? Because the outside world doesn't know that these things still happen. You know, if you tell somebody, like if you speak to anyone in here that in our country, we can't vote, they think that you're crazy. What are you talking about that this happens? Because then you can wake up in the morning and go to the polling station without even thinking, is somebody going to rape me? Just for wearing my MDC t-shirt, or just for wearing this, why should somebody pick on you for wearing your shirt? Huh? You've got the right to vote. It's already been won already. Why can't our politicians change their ways of thinking?